Hello friends, in the previous video you saw some examples related to square and its pattern. In this video we will see some misconceptions and simple mistakes related to them. Let's see an example. Find the squares of the numbers 75 and 76 without multiplying them twice. You can pause the video and think about your answer. Let's solve this. We can find the square of 75 in this way. Many students strive to find the square of 76 in a similar way, which is wrong. Because the method applied here to find out the square of 75 is used to find the square of numbers ending in 5. There are several ways to find the square of 76. One of the methods is given here. Let us now understand the second misconception. Now, think about this sentence. The sum of two consecutive positive integers is a square number. True or false? You can pause the video and think about your answer. Many students assume this sentence to be true. They believe that if all square numbers can be written as the sum of two consecutive positive integers, its inverse will also be true. That is, the sum of two consecutive positive integers will also be a square number. This is a misconception. The sum of two consecutive numbers is not always a square number. For example, the sum of numbers 3 and 4 is 7, which is not a perfect square number. Hence, this statement is false. In this video, we saw some misconceptions and simple mistakes related to square and its pattern. Hope you won't make such mistakes. Thank you.